Next, we have poster 71, titled Body Weight Perception Among Treatment-Seeking Obese Young Adults in Colombo District. The authors are Gamage GP, Hetyarachi P, Jayawardhana R, and Vasulathantri S. The presenting author is Gamage GP.
Good morning, all of you. Thank you very much for the SLMA for the giving this opportunity to present our study findings. And the title of the abstract was Body Weight Perception Among Treatment-Seeking Obese Young Adults in the Colombo District. And as we all know that obesity is considered as a growing epidemic all over the world as well as in Sri Lankan setup. And it is causing for many non-communicable diseases and comorbidities associated with it. Then, hence, by assessing the body weight perception, we expecting the improving the weight reduction practices. Therefore, we did a descriptive cross-sectional study among 261 participants who have BMI greater than 25 kilograms per square meters and aged between 18 to 35 years, attending to a outpatient nutrition clinic of a teaching hospital in the Colombo district. And we used multiple logistic regression and chi-square tests to assess the associations and predictors. And interview administered questionnaire was used. And when it comes to results, a majority of them were nearly 60% were females, and the mean BMI was 29 kilograms per square meters, and mean age was 27.9 years. And when it comes to body weight perception categories, the majority of the participants, though all were obese, perceived themselves as overweight, and only 16.1% perceived themselves accurately as obese. Then when it comes to the predictors, higher BMI was the only predictor of accurate body weight perception, and almost all the participants who had accurate body weight perception had attempted weight reduction before. However, only 54% has obtained professional advices for weight reduction out of them. And when it comes to accurate body weight perception, it was associated with previous attempts of weight reduction as well as professional advice seeking tendency. So in conclusion, higher BMI was the only significant predictor of the body weight perception among this selected group, as well as the tendency for misperceiving body weight perception is prevalent among participants who have lower BMI. And that's all. Thank you.
The poster is open for discussion.
So what clinical implications could you arrive at out of the study finding?
I think it is better to improve their perception regarding their actual body weight, because this is the risk group. They have already been identified as obese and referred for a weight nutrition clinic. So better understanding of their actual status, body weight status, will enhance their weight reduction practices in future, and it will motivate them more, I think so.
Did you sort of find out about how they came to this perception, whether they were measuring their body weight or whether...
Most of them were referred from various clinics due to their other associated comorbidities, maybe due to diabetes mellitus, sometimes maybe due to their joint pains and all. And there were only few self-motivated individuals in the clinic.
And they were not measuring, most of them not actually measuring their body weight.
No, frequently not measuring their body weight.
No, but as the way that you described, I thought that the ones who are with, we'll say BMI 29, they had the good perception. Whereas, or 32, we'll say, they had the good perception. The worst ones had better perception. Milder one only had sort of poor perception.
Yeah.
So basically, say if we put the cutoff 25, what you say is that person with 24.9 had no now we put them on the normal side,
yeah.
And then 25.5 and 26 had no perception.
Yeah.
It corresponded, isn't it?
Yes.
So it's the with regard to cutoff the.
We use that Sri Lankan, that South Asian cutoff given for this one. So that
23.
Yeah, 23 is considered as the normal, and about 25 considered as the obese.
Obese.
Yeah. Right. Okay, thank you.
Please give a round of applause.